Where is everybody? That is the question, the famous Italian physicist Enrico Fermi asked one afternoon, during lunch. This gave rise to the famous Fermi paradox, a conflict between the lack of clear, obvious evidence for extraterrestrial life, and various high estimates for their existence. There have been many attempts to explain the Fermi paradox, primarily suggesting that intelligent extraterrestrial beings are extremely rare, that the lifetime of such civilizations is short, or that they exist, but for various reasons, humans see no evidence. This suggests that at universe time and space scales, two intelligent civilizations would be unlikely ever to meet, even if many developed during the life of the universe. Life outside our solar system might be rare, who knows, but if that is the case, then intelligent life would be rarer. Or, it could be, that we are truly alone in the vastness of space, and I don't know about you, but that makes me feel very, very lonely. So far, we have sent radio signals, we have also sent the Voyager space probes into space, carrying a 12-inch gold-plated copper disc, containing sounds and images selected to portray the diversity of life and culture on Earth, and we have looked towards the direction of our cosmic neighbors in an attempt to make the first contact. But, so far, no one has reached out to us. But aliens, far superior than us, maybe even a Type 3 civilization, is hiding in plain sight and watching our every move. It only makes sense for advanced alien civilizations to not contact us, on purpose. They might be waiting for us. Waiting for us to become able, or at par with them. We cannot, however, be sure. So, the quest to find life outside of our planet must continue. And we just might have found the means to finally do that. Welcome to Lab 360. And today you and I will explore this amazing new way to detect signals from advanced alien civilizations. Let's start with a slice from history. Enter the man who revolutionized theoretical physics and our perception of the cosmos, Albert Einstein. When Einstein published his general theory of relativity in full mathematical detail, it opened the window on a radically new framework for physics, abolishing established notions of space and time, and replacing Newton's formulation of the laws of gravity.
Which will be part of our pie?
Back then, Newton had a godlike stature in the world of physics and astronomy, and challenging his theories obviously did not go well with the scientific community. And, as you can tell, relativity got a lot of flack in its early days. But the rest, as we know, is history. Since then, we have countless proofs of general relativity, even the new images from the James Webb Space Telescope. Shows the bending of space-time around massive celestial objects, and, while doing so, it focuses and magnifies light, like a telescope, in an effect called gravitational lensing. But hold on, visible light might not be the only thing that is affected by this process. Researchers now believe that communication signals might also be amplified through gravitational lensing. And if that's possible, we might even be able to eavesdrop on extraterrestrial communications being relayed around the sun. The idea becomes more interesting as we dive deeper into it. The study theorizes that vast interstellar communication networks could use gravitational lensing to relay transmissions over great distances, similar to how cell phone networks operate here on Earth. We use networks to communicate with each other all the time. When we use a cell phone, the electromagnetic waves are transmitted to the nearest cellular tower, which connects to the next tower, and so on and so forth. If probes are set up in specific positions near a star, to take advantage of its gravitational lensing, they could be used as relay points for this communications network. And, if an advanced alien species has discovered this process, and they happen to be using the sun as a relay point, we'd be able to pick up those signals. Before you dismiss this idea as outlandish, hear me out. We have started taking baby steps towards making this theory a reality. The researchers have tested this hypothesis by collecting data from the Green Bank Telescope in West Virginia, and searching for radio transmissions that might be relayed from our nearest, stellar neighbors located in the Alpha Centauri system. There have been a few previous searches using optical wavelengths, but this time they chose to use radio wavelengths, because radio is a great way to communicate information across space. The search, which was a test, was limited to one night, so anything that wasn't broadcasting while we observed, was not going to get picked up. Although our limited search could miss existing probes, if they weren't constantly broadcasting at these frequencies, this was a good test to see if this kind of search is possible. And the group hopes that gravitational lensing can also be used beyond the search for alien life. We'd also be able to communicate with our own interstellar probes using the same method. Yes, our cosmic towers. For humanity to become multi-planetary, and a spacefaring civilization, we would need methods to communicate back to Earth. The desire to know our place in the universe is a core human yearning, and people have pondered the question for thousands of years. We couldn't move beyond mere speculation for a very long time, however, until we invented telescopes and developed a proper understanding of the scientific method. Humanity notched both of those milestones centuries ago, and science is now going great guns in the search for alien life. But some people, including the late physicist Stephen Hawking, have argued that it's unwise to advertise our presence to aliens, whose nature and intent are complete mysteries to us. These creatures may pillage our planet, after picking up our ping after all. But other researchers think any creatures advanced enough to travel to Earth to enslave or eat us, would already know we're here anyway. And, we might be of no use to these beings, as they would be way up in the Kardashev scale. We, however, have just begun. And we should not stop. In search of life outside of our planet, our technological youth is our biggest advantage. And, if we are truly alone, then it is up to us, to spread humanity, to the far reaches of the cosmos. And in doing so, we may evolve into beings that look nothing like us, but the essence of humanity, the species that started as apes, will forever be etched into our DNA, thousands and thousands of years from now. What do you guys think? Do you think we will ever be able to make the first contact? Have they already tried to contact us, but we couldn't understand? The famous wow signal may have been, truly, an alien civilization trying to reach out to us. Share your thoughts with us. We would like to hear from you. Let us know by dropping in your comments below, and don't forget to subscribe to Lab 360, for all the news and videos from the world of astronomy.